and beautiful wife on tonight, who pushes me and keeps me together like you all are. I love you, honey. Go to the pastor on tonight, and I greet the pastor here out loud. My scripture on tonight, I'm going to be coming from Genesis chapter 22. This is a very familiar scripture, very familiar passage. You all probably have read this, saw this so many times. But tonight, we're going to dig into it, and we're going to see something in the Word on tonight that's going to help all of us, not just one, but it's going to help everybody in the house on tonight, including myself. I believe everybody in the house can pull something from this Word on tonight. So if you open up your hearts, open up your mind, open up your spirit, I guarantee you, you're going to be blessed tonight. Topic on tonight, I'm going to be talking about real obedience.
Yes, Jesus.
Real obedience.
Work it up.
Well, Abraham operated in obedience, not just one time, but every time God came to him, Abraham was able to operate in obedience. So on tonight, I'm going to try to teach a little bit on that, because see, that's something that we need in the body of Christ. We don't need to just operate in obedience when God comes to us one time, but we're supposed to operate in obedience when God comes to us every time we ask for him. In chapter 22, you know, where God comes and God began, you know, to speak to Abraham again. And God told him, say, Abraham, I need you to do this one thing. I just need you to get up right now, stop what you're doing, take your son and go and offer him unto me a burnt offering, a sacrifice.
Yeah.
We know, and like sometimes, you know, this can be a hard thing. This was his only son at the moment.
Yeah.
And it ain't easy to take your only son, off of your only son, you know, that God has gave you or that you don't produce at this moment, and put him on an altar for him to be killed.
Come on.
So, and I looked at it and I said, God, that's just something that we in the body of Christ, we would have struggled with that thing so much that we would have been saying, God, no, I can't do that right there, God. God, I love you. I'm gone. Later on down in the verse, well, he got up and did it.
Yeah, yeah.
He didn't murmur, he didn't complain, he didn't do all that what we would do.
Yeah.
As the body of Christ, that's what we would do. Yeah. We'll complain, we'll murmur, we'll talk against it, we'll do all that, we'll kick back. You know, we'll go to our brother, our sister, you know, say, hey, you heard that? Would you do that? Sister, would you do that? Brother, would you do that? Mama, would you do that? Would you take your only son and offer him as a burnt offering?
Y'all can't call the son.
Like he did way back in chapter 12. He didn't murmur, he didn't prompt, he didn't stab, he didn't do none of that.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
He girded up his loin, he gave up everything that he did, and he obeyed God.
Yes.
That's real obedience, thanks to God.
Yes.
That's real obedience. We talk, but we really can't walk the walk. No, we got to go, you know, way down the corner, around the corner and all that before we obey God. We got to do this, we got to do that, we got to do all the things that we want to do before we obey God. But that ain't what God wants us to do. God wants us to obey him right then and there. God wants us to obey him when he tells us to do it, when he wants us to do it right then and there. Not a day later, not a month later, not a year later, but when God gives you a charge, when God gives you a command, God is expecting you to do it right here. God is expecting you to operate off of that right in the deal. He ain't telling you to go home and think about it. He ain't telling you to go home and take a drink and sit down and think about something that we do.
Yeah.
He always give us a chance, not a chance, not a chance, not a chance. And when he do that, he don't really come and beat us up like we do. We beat ourselves up.
Right.
He don't do that. He just give me a chance to get right back where he was, little baby.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So we got to be in this season. We can't beat ourselves up.
Right.
If you didn't obey, start obeying.
That's right.
If you need to obey, start today, start tonight. All throughout Abraham's life, he was tested.